Okay guys, so this is a video in a series of videos that I wanted to start doing on this channel where I focus on trying to help those players who are brand new to Rainbow Six Siege. Rainbow Six Siege has one of the biggest learning curves of any first-person shooter that I've ever seen, and I think that this game does a very poor job at helping those who are brand new to the game. When you play Siege for the first time, it's like you're just being thrown into the fire and it's up to you to figure out what is going on. And I think that that's a big problem with this game. I believe that a lot of people go on to quit playing Siege because they find it too difficult in the beginning. Ubisoft, I don't think, does a good job at helping new players, and I don't really see a ton of resources on YouTube dedicated specifically to helping brand new players. It's more or less intermediate and advanced guides. And so in this video, I'm going to be talking about barrel attachments, and I think that's one thing that Ubisoft does not do a good job at explaining to new players. So in this video, I'm going to give a brief rundown and explanation as to what these attachments do and which attachments you should consider running for different weapons. Okay, so to start this video out, I want to get what I believe to be the most useless attachment out of the way, and that is the suppressor. The suppressor is a weapon attachment that you would only want to run for a specific operator, maybe like a Nook or an IQ. Nook, because obviously her whole thing is trying to be silent, and IQ so that she can put it on her secondary and get gadgets undetected. Other than that, it's really not worth bringing simply because the suppressor does not reduce the recoil at all. Not only does it not reduce recoil, it reduces a weapon's damage by 15%. However, there are some positives to the suppressor. The suppressor does not trigger a white threat indicator for your enemies like other weapons, and the flash is hidden from it. However, barrel attachments aren't typically picked for their ability to hide flashes, but to simply just reduce recoil. So when it comes to the suppressor, I don't think it's worth bringing for most weapons. I mean, do it if you want a meme, but it's really not worth bringing. So next we have the muzzle brake, and this is one of my favorite attachments, but you know, just don't go start picking it just because I like it. Some players will benefit more from this attachment than others. It all just depends on your ability to control recoil. But what's the purpose of a muzzle brake? Well, the muzzle brake reduces the first shot recoil by 45%, along with a 45% reduction for the recentering of shots. And so since the first shot recoil is greatly decreased, weapons such as pistols and DMRs, which are semi-automatic, get the most benefit from the muzzle brake attachment. In fact, you should always run a muzzle brake on a semi-automatic weapon, considering every shot will have a reduced recoil of 45%. And as for what it means by recentering time, that just means how quick the weapon goes back to its starting position after shooting it. So if you shoot a weapon with a muzzle brake, it'll get back on target 45% quicker than if you didn't. And while I say that you should always run the muzzle brake on semi-automatic weapons, that doesn't mean that you should refrain from using it on automatic weapons. If there is a weapon that has a vertical recoil and really not that much of a horizontal recoil, that weapon would most likely benefit from a muzzle brake. For example, I use the muzzle brake on Sledge's L85. I think that's a weapon that is great for muzzle brake because it has some vertical recoil, but not really any horizontal recoil. And the same thing goes for Buck's C8. Those are weapons that it's more beneficial to have the muzzle brake attachment, because with those weapons, you're gonna have to worry more about vertical recoil than horizontal recoil. And the next barrel attachment we have is the compensator. And this weapon attachment is the exact opposite of the muzzle brake. Where the muzzle brake works to reduce the vertical recoil and climb of the weapon, the compensator works to reduce the horizontal recoil of the weapon or its ability to go side to side. So one thing that you need to understand about how the weapons in Siege work is that each weapon has what is called a diamond. You can't really see this diamond, but it's there. And you'll notice that whenever you shoot a weapon, the recoil pattern is never exactly the same whenever you shoot it. If that was the case, we would have people dumping 30 round mags and they would stay on target every time because they could just memorize the exact recoil pattern. However, even though they're not in the exact recoil pattern, they do stay within this invisible recoil diamond. Now, some diamonds are smaller, some are larger, some are taller, and some are wider. And so that random recoil diamond ensures that all the bullets will remain within that diamond. So for example, Ella's Scorpion, it has an insane amount of horizontal recoil that can become uncontrollable with long bursts. So that is a weapon that has a very large recoil diamond. And then you can look at Capcan's SMG, which is the 9x19 VSN, which has very little horizontal and vertical recoil, giving it a much smaller diamond. And so what the compensator does is it reduces the size of this random recoil diamond by 17.75%. So if you shoot a weapon like LS Scorpion or Mirror's Vector that has quite a bit of horizontal recoil, you may want to slap a compensator on it. Or really just any other weapon that you notice has a ton of side-to-side movement whenever you burst it. The next barrel attachment is the flash hider. And as you could probably tell by the name, the flash hider reduces the flash on the end of your barrel. But to put it simply, the flash hider is a mix of both the muzzle brake as well as the compensator. It reduces the first shot recoil by 37.5%, it has a resetting time of 30%, and a random recoil diamond of 5%. So it literally takes the best of both worlds by mitigating some horizontal and some vertical recoil. In my experience, this is the most used barrel attachment because of its ability to mediate both horizontal and vertical recoil. I think this is an attachment that's best suited for the majority of the weapons in this game, but it's really up for the player to decide if it's for them. I personally think that the flash hider should be used on weapons that start out with some vertical recoil and over time become more horizontal with the recoil. So for example, you know, Twitch's F2 has a fair amount of vertical recoil within the first few shots, and then over time you'll see it starts to move side to side while shooting. So that would be an example of a weapon that I would consider using the flash hider on. And I think that if you're someone who really can't tell that much difference between the different barrel attachments and you're cycling through them and you can't tell that much of a difference, I think your best bet would probably just to go with the flash hider, because again, it's not the best in terms of maintaining vertical recoil, it's not the best for horizontal recoil, but it is the best of both worlds in a sense. You're not going too far one way or the other. And as for the last attachment, we have the extended barrel. Now, this attachment does nothing to mitigate recoil, and all it does is just reduce the damage drop-off of the weapon by 15 to 20%. This is an attachment where it really just depends on whether or not you can control the recoil with one. For example, I think the P10 Roni has, you know, such little recoil that I'm comfortable running an extended barrel on it. However, you won't see me running the extended barrel on the SMG11. So this is really an attachment that you'll have to test out for yourself. Just, you know, try the weapon with what you usually use and then try with the extended barrel and see if you can maintain the recoil still with the extended barrel. And if so, go ahead and slap it on there. And so that's it. That is all the attachments. And I apologize if you came here looking for me to tell you which attachment you should be using for every single gun in the game. I don't think that I can accurately do that, considering that I'm on PC and a vast majority of you guys are on console. On PC, recoil is not as big of a problem as it is on console. And so what I would run probably looks different from what you probably need, especially if you're a new player. Like, for example, I can run the P10 Roni with an extended barrel, but there are probably many console players, and especially new players, who wouldn't be able to. While I may be able to control the horizontal recoil on a weapon like, you know, the MX4 Storm, some players, especially newer players, may not be able to. So while I'm not telling you exactly what you should be using for each weapon, you should have an idea as to what you should be running based on how easily you can currently manage recoil. So to reiterate, muzzle brake reduces vertical, compensator reduces horizontal, flash hider does both but less effectively, the suppressor is generally useless, and run the extended barrel if recoil isn't that much of a problem for you. Thank you guys for sticking around to the end of the video. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like, that helps me out a lot with YouTube algorithm, and subscribe for more content. Also, I'm looking to make more videos to help newer players, so if you're a newer player, let me know down below what you're struggling with, and if you've been playing Siege for a while, let me know what you struggled with as a new player. That's it for today. I'm the Senator, and as always, have a good one.